Hi, in this video we're going to be having a look at the TCP IP four-layer model. Now the four-layer model is used to communicate over the internet and it's the most common set of protocols available. The first layer is the application layer. Now this lays out the rules for how the software applications are going to work, and that includes web browsers as well as email systems and file transfer systems. The next layer is the transport layer. Now this sets up the rules for how two devices are going to communicate together. So it'll say the size of the packets they're going to use, they would agree the language that's used, that sort of thing. The next layer is the internet layer, and this sets the data. So it addresses each of the packets, it splits up into the packets, and it finds a particular route through the internet to the destination. And it may find more than one route, depending on what's happening at the time. And the final layer is the link layer, and this is the hardware that's used. And that involves the rules for how the network interface card works, as well as the operating system and things like that. Now each layer can only directly communicate with the layer directly above or below it. So for instance, the application layer can only communicate with the transport layer. The transport layer can communicate with the application layer, but also the internet layer. The internet layer can communicate with the transport layer and the link layer, and the link layer can only communicate with the internet layer. So let's have a look at each of those layers in a little bit more detail. The first layer that we'll look at is the application layer. This layer is concerned with the applications that are used to send messages over the internet. And there's three ways this is done. This could be done through web pages, through email, or even file transfer. So we'll have a look at some of the protocols used with each of these. First one we look at is HTTP. This is the hypertext transfer protocol, and it defines how web pages are formatted and transmitted and how web servers should cope with the commands on web pages. HTTPS, a hypertext transfer protocol secure, is a secure version of HTTP. This encrypts all the data sent between the browser and the web page. These are often used for payment pages on websites. Now we'll have a look at some of the email application protocols. Smtp stands for Simple Mail Transfer Protocol, and this defines how email messages are sent between servers. IMAP is the Internet Message Access Protocol, and it defines how email messages are stored on a mail server and allows the end user to view and manipulate the messages as though they were stored locally on their own computer. POP stands for the Post Office Protocol, and this defines how messages are extracted and retrieved from the remote mail server. Finally, we'll have a look at FTP. This is the File Transfer Protocol, and this is a standard network protocol that is used to transfer files between computers, and it can be used on LANs and WANs as well as the internet. Next, we'll have a look at the transport layer. The TCP Transmission Control Protocol is one of the original protocols designed in the TCP IP suite, hence the name of the model. It breaks down the data into packets, adds a header to each segment that contains the total number of packets and where that packet appears in the sequence, so it can be reassembled later. It then sends the packets to the internet layer. There is an alternative to the TCP, and that's the UDP, the User Datagram Protocol. This is an alternative, and it's slightly more simplified. In the internet layer, this really is dominated by the IP, the Internet Protocol, and this is responsible for delivering a packet of data from a source network to the destination network. It adds to the packet header and includes the original source IP address and the destination IP address, and it uses routing tables to find a suitable route to send the packets. Finally, we'll have a look at the link layer. This layer is responsible for actually delivering the packets of data from the source network to its destination network, and this uses the network interface card and the operating system.